Let's take a look at an example of doing a curve pattern. First, I'm going to suppress this sweep for a moment just to show you that we have a curve and another curve that I'm going to use to create an extrude and then pattern that extrude along the curve. Let's resume the sweep. And I will start off by selecting this curve, and from the mini toolbar, let's create an extrude. And I can right mouse click and hold and choose to remove material. For the depth in the first direction, let's make it 2 next. And I can right click and hold and define a side 2 depth, which will also be 2 next. That's good for my cut. Let's hit the check mark or the middle mouse button. And with the extrude still selected, if I hold down the right mouse button, I can create a pattern. And by default, it's going to give me a dimension pattern. If I hold down the right mouse button again from the mini toolbar, I can change the type of the pattern to a curve pattern. And now you'll notice that the references tab is in red. Also, the collector for the sketch in the dashboard is red. You could define an internal sketch within the feature, but we already have a sketch to use, so I will select it. And here we see the value for the spacing. Let me zoom out a little bit and you can see the previews of all the different instances. And you can change the spacing of the instances in here. Also, you have the preview dots. If for whatever reason you didn't want to generate a few of these instances, you could click on the dots. And then when you middle mouse button to complete the feature, those instances won't be created. Since the pattern is still selected, I can hold down the right mouse button and edit definition. Clicking on the preview dots will bring those individual instances back. And in addition to controlling the spacing between instances, sometimes it's easier to control the number of members along the curve to ensure that you have even spacing. And let's crank this up to a value of 50, and then I can hit the check mark. And zooming out, you can see that I have my curve pattern created. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you learned something from this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you like this video, please click the subscribe button to be informed when new videos are uploaded. Thank you very much.